This video is brought to you by Jergens, manufacturing efficiency.
If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hi, and thanks for joining us on Tooling Up. I'm your host, Toni Neary, and we're thrilled you're here with us on the MSC YouTube channel. If you're new, don't forget to click subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming episodes, and don't forget to hit that like button. Today, I am thrilled to be filming at Jergens here in Cleveland, which is actually where my manufacturing journey started just over 18 years ago. And I'm thrilled to have Vice President Matt Schron and Product Manager Mike Antos here. Thanks for joining me today, guys.
Pleasure.
So one of the interesting things about Jergens is the family history. And I think, Matt, you're the perfect person to tell us a little bit about the Jergens story.
Yeah. So we were founded in 1942 during World War II. So we were making airplane seat components for the wartime efforts. After the war, many people got into the job shop environment making parts for everybody else. At that time, Jergens decided to make standard components for all of those companies and that kind of stuff, selling them the standard components. So we have grown from that point to be one of the world leaders in standard components, helping to support everybody from the aerospace market, defense department, medical, automotive, and even the job shops as well too.
And I think something fascinating is you are a fourth generation for the Schron family here running the business. And I think innovation has come through all of those different generations. Tell me a little bit about the changes you've seen in the business since you've been here.
You know, we started making standard components, standard stuff. And we were trying to make the world's best standard components. And our tagline 20 years ago was the standard components with the highest standards. And we had the most standard components. As businesses change, manufacturing companies had to change as well with it too, right? So they had to sit down there and evolve. So now they went from hopefully fixturing and setups into how can they change over faster. So that's when we came up with one of the first quick change fixturing designs, ball lock, which we're still using today, which helps you change a fixture over from what used to be like 45, 50 minutes to set up on a job. We're doing it now in a matter of 5 to 10 minutes. So we have other options to quick change and set up our customers' products as well too. And I think today we're continuing to innovate. We're doing things with automation setups. So I think we're always trying to understand where the customer's at, what their needs are, and trying to adapt to those changes as well too.
And I think innovation leads to longevity in your workforce. And Mike, I know that you've been here for more than a minute, right? Tell us a little bit about your journey here at Jergens, when you started, how long you've been there, and what your role looks like today.
Yeah, I actually started at Jergens when I was going to college down the road at Cleveland State University. That was 18 years ago. So I was fortunate enough to graduate from there with an engineering degree and stay on at Jergens. And it's really been great. I've had experience here doing design engineering, applications engineering, supporting our sales staff, working some, back in the shop with our quality department. So it's been great so far.
And Workholding is one of the staples of the Jergens lines. Tell us a little bit about the evolution that you've seen with the products in your role.
Yeah, so with Workholding, we're kind of fitting the needs as typically we're providing products that are going into machining centers. So, as machining centers evolve, we're designing and developing products, custom solutions to fit those needs.
And I think we're seeing so much adoption with 5-axis out in the marketplace. Tell us a little difference about your Workholding devices for 5-axis versus some of the other ones out there.
Yeah, so with 5-axis, just like any of the solutions we try to provide with the Workholding, the quick change is a big aspect of that. So we're providing, whether it's a combination of our standard products or standard products incorporated with some of our custom products, quick change, whether it be our quick lock system, our basic grid system, or our ball lock system, and then incorporating that with our 5-axis self-centering vise as the top tooling component. That's really become the core of our 5-axis line.
And time is money. So I would imagine these processes and these products are going to save time and money when you're looking at transitions and changing out for different components that people are machining.
Yeah. So one of the big features with this vise is the jaws are very quick change. So just in a matter of seconds without any tools, I can change out the jaws on this vise. I can change out. So our standard jaws, this serrated jaw here you see for typically doing first op work where you want to penetrate into the material, have a very aggressive type of holding. But in a matter of seconds, you can either reverse these jaws to hold a larger or smaller workpiece or go to a machinable soft jaw. In some older designs of 5-axis vices, it was quite difficult to recenter the jaws if you ever had to maybe you had a crash or you had to disassemble the vise for maintenance or change out a part. With these vises, you can recenter the opening of the jaws usually in a matter of a minute or two. It's very simple. In most cases, you do not have to even take the vise off of your machine. It can be done right on the machine.
All right, Mike, so you're an engineer. This is your product. I imagine that you probably want to get into some of the specifics about what makes this product so amazing.
Yeah, so one of the big things with any vises is jaw lift, and how do you to minimize that? So with these vises, we talked about the quick change jaws, but also these feature a very aggressive pull down mechanism on the jaw interface and how it connects to the jaw carrier. So with this vise, in most cases, you're going to see very minimal, if not no lift. So that's a big thing. Also, we have some patented technology with the lead screw and how it connects inside the vise, actually allowing a little bit of float in the vertical direction that actually helps us in combination with that jaw connection to minimize jaw lift and also create just a more efficient clamping action within the vise.
That's fantastic. And I know, Matt, you touched on it earlier, but looking at how you serve your customers, I mean, everybody has different products, they have different technology. What's the real differentiator with Jergens?
Yeah, I think that's what really separates us. I mean, I think I saw a study one time that was talking about products and services, and people are almost 80% of the time are buying their products based on the services that they're being provided, not necessarily the product that they're actually buying. And I believe that's what really separates Jergens. We made significant investments in the last few years in trying to invest in what we're seeing the change in the marketplace. So a lot of shops have started to eliminate tool rooms and design fixture design people. So what we've really done is invest in those areas to help support those customers. So we have a custom design build facility in California that can do fixture build for you guys. But in addition to that, we've got technical engineers that are out there here to support you. We work with, you know, MSC very closely with their cutting tool specialists in the field as well too, to design solutions for customers, helping them with the fixturing layout, support, showing them exactly what they do. And then those guys, I refer to those as my napkin guys. They're the guys that go out there, they're in front of the customer, drawing the designs and that kind of stuff. And they're the concept people. Then they bring it back to our application team. We've got a group of about 8 application engineers here just doing designs and drawings for these fixtures. So when you wanted to take one of these 5-axis vices Mike's talking about and put it into a solution and design a fixture, whether it be a tombstone, whether it be a subplate, whether it be a 5-axis riser solution, we have those application engineers that will help you design it, optimize it, and make it more efficient so you can make more parts quicker, faster, and hopefully make your company more money.
All right. Well, Matt and Mike, I want to thank you so much for taking the time today. This has been amazing, and it's great to see the product innovations. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed our conversation here with Matt and Mike as much as I did to see the innovative solutions that Jergens developing for 5-axis machining. You can always reach out to your MSC metalworking specialist, and you can also go to the website at www.mscdirect.com/Jergens. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level, and subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.